All right, guys, we made it to, where are we at?
We are at NOLA Motorsports. Is it?
Park.
Park, yeah. NOLA. Well, it doesn't say the whole thing ever. It just always has NOLA Motorsports.
Yeah.
If you look at Google Maps. All right, we're at NOLA Motorsports Park today. This is the coolest track. You've ever been here?
No.
The kart track is amazing. The skid pad is like glass, like in a good way.
Yeah.
And they have a huge road course, which we never do.
Yeah. But how late am I?
Oh God, you're like 5 days. I don't know, Ian, how long have we been going? With travel days? We're on the fourth.
I left like a week and a half ago.
You left on Tuesday, and the Tuesday that you left, I pulled the motor out of my car.
How did you get so much time off of work?
And they did the head.
Because Corona, I didn't take anything.
In advance, he's like, hey, I'm going to be a few days late. I'm going to miss the first track. I was like, if you miss the first track, don't show up to the second. You're not invited.
Well, I didn't show up to that one either, so I showed up at the third.
Yeah. And he's like, I know Aaron's not going to kick me out, which I won't, because I like Trevor. So, here he is.
Yeah, I was 18 hours straight. We made it, so I guess we're just going to do a little driver's meet. I need to get a windshield banner from you.
Yeah, we're out.
Oh, you're out?
Yeah.
Okay.
I don't know where they all went. We made 50, and we gave out 30, and there's 20 missing. Yeah,
maybe I'll
we'll find
maybe
it, but like
cut somebody else's in half and we'll share it and we'll just drive next to each other.
That'll work.
All right, guys, gonna do a quick little round of a pit walk, kind of show you guys what's going on here. So we have some cars over here. Jason's over there. We have a I think that's Daniel Brockett over there in the IS300. I believe that's him. Those guys are over there working on the car. The Hoonigan guys actually drove a truck in a trailer. I think Hurt is actually driving. Hurt's driving that thing, driving it on the road, but they're also towing Rob Parsons' car, which he's his legs don't work, so he's basically hand controlled driving that. So I don't think he's actually driving it. It's in the trailer, but they have like their tires and stuff, I think, with them. Got Rudy over here. He brought his trailer, but not to drive his car. He's been driving. You've been driving the car on the street, right?
Oh yeah.
So he basically drove this whole thing from Idaho, right? Did you drive from Idaho or did you just start?
Nope, we started in Arizona.
Yeah.
So we've already done like 22 hours though.
Yeah.
And it's like 115 in that car probably.
Yeah.
So hot. So hot.
Yeah. The AC and my, in your Corvette we have some wind noise.
That's it. It's so loud. No floor, no carpet, no insulation.
No weather stripping. No. Yeah, this is like a pro-am car.
Yeah, the doors I just put on it.
Yeah.
With the windows in it for this trip, yeah.
That's crazy.
So that's about the only thing we've had it in the kit a little better.
But his trailer is basically serving as support for other drivers with their tires and tools and all that stuff. This whole thing is basically full of tires. So Rudy is still driving his car with his wife and he's having somebody else drive the truck and trailer, which is pretty cool. Yeah. But Rudy, if you guys don't remember, that was the C4 Corvette.
The burn down. The last, the Grange.
Yeah.
Yeah. But whatever. I think we got. Oh, so let's go check this out. We got these guys helping us out. They're called TKO clamps. And actually, you can, my sponsor just hooked us up with this. And all you got to do is grab that right there, and this will come off of it. You don't have to unbuckle it and do it like a regular fire extinguisher.
You just yank it.
Just yank it. Boom, and it's off in your hand. And then the material that's in it, you can like, it's clean right when you're done spraying it within. It encapsulates it with some type of foam, and then it goes away and it's clean and you don't have to clean it off and you can use it minutes later.
That's dope. So, yeah, that's nice. I definitely need to get some fire stuff in the Corvette too.
No, this thing's good. I'm glad to have you back out here. And
suppression system and another fire extinguisher.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
So, yeah.
Then we have some more guys over here. You get a little clown shoe. Those guys run in Lone Star Drift. And this guy right here, he actually, this little E46, blew up a motor in it, replaced the motor, dyno tuned it, redid it, and has been towing a trailer with it. So he's been through lots of hell with this thing. Pretty cool to see him continuing. Basically, we have a group chat on Facebook, and I've just been like watching everybody else's updates and all the issues that they've been having. So, and here are the other guys from Colorado. As you guys know, I drove Ian C6 a couple months ago, compared it to the Mustang.
He's in full Corvette attire today.
I didn't bring, I wore the jorts for the first day. Man, I never realized how uncomfortable jorts are. It's like, I need to stretch.
You need to stretch it. But Ian's basically doing this trip by himself, but he's tripping doing good.
Yeah, we're at like 3,000 miles. I've done well over 100 laps between all the tracks. Yeah. We've been getting some frisky tans. So, or spicy tandems going on. Actually took Dan Brockett's bumper off yesterday.
Damn. I've seen the boops on the highway, the 90 mile an hour boops.
Yeah, it was fun.
And then this is all the stuff you have in your car.
This is Levi's.
So Levi, Drift Colorado.
I came here with all of this on this tarp plus four rims.
Oh, wow. Inside, not even.
So I didn't have a single rim up front.
Yeah.
I fit all rims in the hatch.
But you don't have a passenger, though.
Yeah, but I could have done it, like, our luggage would have been real tight.
Yeah.
But we could have done it with a passenger.
Yeah.
It would have just been tight on the way here. But once we got here, offloaded the wheels into Rudy's trailer, and then it isn't that bad. Like, all that shit easily fits in the back now.
Yeah. That's good. And then Levi, he has the C5 Vet, but he actually has an FD RX-7 front bumper on it. He actually got in a little bit of a wreck with it and basically had to rebuild his lower radiator support, corner lights. He ended up finding another like RX-7 front bumper and basically pieced this whole thing together. So he spent like 2 days fixing his car during this whole trip. But yeah, and then we got Aaron's trailer, Lone Star Drift. This is basically the only trailer that we had with us last year, which this thing was just jam-packed all the way with tires and tools. But this year there's more drivers. I think there's closer to 30 drivers instead of like 14. So that's why there's the second trailer for support. And then we have my Corvette over here. I think what we're gonna do is wrap these lights in some yellow film. I think that'll be pretty cool, kind of tie everything in together. But yeah, now we got the roof rack off of here, sitting over here on the ground. We got the wheels and tires waiting for the Valeno tire guys to get here, be able to throw some tires on there and basically leave those tires and wheels in their trailer. And then we have all of our luggage and stuff basically right here. Just storing it in. This is Zach from ECU Master, his trailer. Just kind of pitting with him for the day because he just basically towed his JZX over here to hang out with us for the day. He's not going to do the full drift week.
some more. So I think those are my first Corvette tandems of the day. Did some Corvette tandems with Ian. It was Rudy in his S13. Just was kind of checking over the tires. They looked really good on the inside, but right now, or on the outside, but the inner on the other side has a little bit of camber, so it's eating that inside a lot more. The inside is actually down to cords on that side. Whereas this tire almost looks like 30% tread all over it. So I'm gonna go back and play with the alignment just a little bit, and then bring it back out. Laps today I did probably like I'd say 30 laps. So we did about 30 laps with the car, just kind of the base settings that we have driving it here, which I don't even know if maybe some of this happened driving here. But you could see, I think that's just some camber wear right there on these actual tires, because the outside is actually pretty good, but then as it goes in, it's just really wearing right here. So that could be a little bit of toe stuff, but I wouldn't assume that it would wear it like that just as much. So just playing with some of the settings. I've never really adjusted anything on the back of a Corvette before, so we're just kind of learning. Grab some of these Tecton tools. As you guys know, 10% off using code MOTIONAUTO during Drift Week, which is November 4th through the 17th. So if you guys want some Tecton tools, again, I love this set. It just has pretty much everything you need. But I'm gonna go ahead and start playing with some of these adjustments. Danny, he's got a C6. He came over and helped me out.
Yeah, I'm not a Corvette tech or genius or anything, but just from my basic knowledge.
You're in the C6 over there with Harrison.
Yeah.
You guys are doing it right. You're like sharing the car.
Yeah, we're co-driving.
Are you guys splitting the cost of everything too?
Yeah. So everything's like split.
That's like the way to do it.
It'd be cool if you had like a four-door car in it.
But then if they break the car, then you kind of got to be mad at them though.
I don't really care. But I know Harrison's really easy.
Yeah,
on cars,
Harrison's a good driver though. So
we're doing this on like 10 tires, I think, or 12 tires. So
see, I bought 28, and I haven't even used one pair yet. So
I don't know. I think it'll turn some.
We're doing a little challenge in the ECU Master 350Z. As you guys know, ECU Master's been a sponsor of me for a couple years, but this is their basically stock 350Z. And we're doing a little like YouTuber challenge between like me, Adam, some of the other guys that have channels around here, to see who could get the Z the closest, basically parking it, sliding it into the tires is what we're trying to do.
No, this is gonna work. This is gonna work.
Yeah. Zach, it ran out of gas.
Thank you.
Who's next? Who's next? No, 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 no. Impossible, you can't even like get in there.
Good job, Trevor.
All right, now they move.
Well, I mean, he parked. Oh!
I've done worse to the car, we're good. It's just a tire.
Better if I didn't like chicken out right at the last second with that popping sound.
Here.
That scared me. That was really loud. Okay, we won.
Brandon Wicknick.
Well,
it's about time.
Thank
that
you.
I win something on Drift Week.
Good job.
Thank you.
Boom. All right, let's go back to the big track. Oh yeah.
Oh!
There we go.
Oh!
What I've always wanted.
Novelty treats.
It's 24-7
real. Brandon, you gotta break it on your
You gotta finish it, Brandon.
24.
You need it.
Brandon,
we need a shot.
What?
Break it on your head.
Oh, God, here we go.
No, don't do it. Don't do it. You just want, you don't need, no.
Does it break, it bends.
Hey, nice car.
What am I? I'm a 50. Should we do, maybe that could be a new segment. I just act like I'm something and then you gotta guess in the comments what it is by making a noise. So that is day one of our drift week. Showed up late, but I think we showed up in style with the Corvette how it is. I let Adam drive it there towards the end of the night. I don't know how much of that stuff you're able to see come across on the GoPro. It was pretty dark, but he's in love with it. He loves how much side bite it has, and basically said that it just feels like unlike anything else. It's just its own driving car. It doesn't drive like an S chassis, doesn't drive like anything. It drives like a freaking crazy Corvette with a bunch of side bites. So it's cool to get feedback and stuff on the car. I'll probably maybe convince him to drive it again tomorrow and maybe like go through some tow settings and like go dial it in a little bit more. Basically hack the system by like letting him hit him figure it out for me, just because he's so much more experienced driving. But yeah,
Car literally, no issues with it whatsoever, other than the window seals. But even just driving it around on the street now, without the roof rack, it just feels like a completely different car. It's not as loud. It just feels like there's less fatigue driving it around, as well as getting the exhaust flaps closed, so it's a little bit quieter. But it's just cool. Hop in it, Bluetooth radio, AC. You know, it's just a cool car. But yeah, wouldn't be possible without you guys. And again, huge shout out to all the people that kind of hopped on board literally last minute with me. E-Trailer, BC Racing, Koenig Wheels, Hooker, basically Exhaust, and Holly, you know, for the intake stuff, as well as Texas Speed, Tecton Tools, obviously, which still, they have the code, and links in description, and Build Team Race for tuning this thing literally like the past two nights right before we left, staying there to all hours of the night. But yeah. Drift week, here we come, man. I'm tired. Hotel bed after 4 days of no bed at all. So I'm stoked. But yeah, stay tuned for tomorrow's content, and see you guys later.